We founded our company in 2010 as Canadian Clean Energy Conferences. And to start off, we were just doing events really focused on renewables in Canada. So we did a whole series of events on different provincial procurements for renewable energy. So the Ontario feed-in tariff, there was a procurement in Nova Scotia we did events on, and up until last year we did an event on Alberta and Saskatchewan's procurement for renewable energy. So that's really where we got started. And about, well, I guess it's 9 years ago now, we started to look at the development for or business opportunities for renewables was starting to move away from these government-backed power purchase agreements and more towards opportunities directly with end buyers. So whether that's remote communities or mining companies. And through a conversation, a rather detailed conversation I had with Barrick Gold, we decided to launch a conference on renewable energy for the mining sector. So that was 9 years ago. And now we've done over 17 events on that topic. So specifically around how mines are integrating renewable energy to address, first of all, price issues, cost issues, but now more and more carbon issues. So it's a subject I'm very passionate about, and it's a topic that is very hot right now in the resource sector. And so, that's kind of my background.
You know, you have this perspective of, you know, these 15 years, I think you mentioned, and already then there was this investor inquiry or, you know, question raising around emissions. And how have you seen that kind of migrate? You know, can you maybe talk to us a little bit about how you've seen that progress? What, you know, was it just a growth in awareness? Were there certain things that happened? Like, how has that progressed in terms of investors wanting to see us manage that carbon risk better?
Yeah, it's a really exciting time right now. I'd say the last year, perhaps even maybe 6 months, we've seen the biggest developments, and that's with the major, strictly speaking on the mining side, with the big mines like BHP and Anglo American and Rio setting midterm targets for 2030 and setting high ambitious carbon reduction targets. That is a direct reflection of the pressure they're feeling from investors and customers. So we're seeing sort of this really interesting time where investors are getting really serious about this. And part of this is about the Paris Agreement and being able to meet those targets and wanting to see that the companies they're invested in are actually have not only address that, but have a concrete plan to reach those targets. So that's the shift that I think you're describing, is not only are they kind of setting these ambitious carbon reduction targets, they're now feeling pressure to actually lay out a plan to meet those. So that's where we're seeing a lot of activity, and that's I think the big, big change. And when you see the, and that's been described to us in our events and many of the conversations we've had, in particular with the mining sector, around what they're hearing from shareholders, is it's not enough to have this sort of strategic vision of what you'd like to do in terms of reducing your exposure. Now you have to have a plan, and a plan involves, you know, testing a variety of technologies, collaborating with other companies, and really trying to seek out government support in some cases to really get to their targets. Because right now there's no, that right now everyone will miss them unless there is a lot of work done in the next 10 years. So that to me is the really exciting thing, is that not only do we have, and I think it's all in line with the Paris Agreement and investors wanting their investors feeling a responsibility, right, to demonstrate that they're investing in responsible companies, some investors pulling completely out of carbon intensive companies and making a big statement there. And then the other piece related to carbon is customers. And we're seeing that, you know, customers like Apple has said that they're going to have 100% carbon neutral supply chain and product by 2030. So that's a big deal. And that really impacts the material sector and other sectors that are supplying to those big companies. So customers are demanding sustainable products. So that's making it so that you can't sell to them unless you've done your job in reducing your carbon emissions. So I'd say investors and customers, it's been a major sea change, and we won't see that let up. It'll just increase and intensify.